Yo, Cleverlike here with a new Minecraft add-on tutorial. This time we are going to show you how to take your custom built behavior pack and share it with your friends. So you want to make a mcpack file out of your custom behavior, something like this. Let's say you made your own little exploding arrows add-on like that. And you want to share this with your friends so they can play it on their Pocket Edition or the Windows 10 Edition. This is, again, this is vanilla Minecraft and using a behavior pack add-on. So you want to share this with people so they could use it on their iPad. Let me show you how that is done. It's not too terribly hard. So, that's kind of fun though. So what we're going to do is kind of pause this here and gonna go check out our files. Okay, so in my behavior packs folder, I have the exploding arrows add-on that I created. And if we look at that, it has the pack manifest file. And in the entities folder, I only have the arrows.json because that is the only file that was changed. Again, when you're publishing these, you want to remove anything that you don't change. Delete it out of the folders and just include the files that you're changing. And you must create a custom UUID for your pack manifest. So if you don't do this right, then it's not going to work. So you have to get this done in advance. So when you edit your manifest, make sure, don't just pick something random. What you want to do is you want to get a UUID created, and I've got a utility. There's a number of them out there. I created one on cleverlike.com/UUID. Every time you refresh the page, it creates a brand new, completely unique and original forever UUID that you can use. Okay, so you should get one of those whenever you are producing your own add-ons. And we're going to put the UUID here, which I've already done, and I've got a unique UUID there, which I've already done. So make sure you don't copy mine. Go get your own. And that's what you're going to need. I've got the name that's going to show up and the description, and everything's set and ready to go. So make sure you do that first. If you don't do that properly, then all this work is not going to pay off. So next thing I'm going to do, I'm on Windows 10, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight the contents of my exploding arrows folder. I'm going to right click once they're all selected, and I'm going to say send to compressed zip folder. Now, one of the important things here is we want to make sure that we have our viewing of file name extensions turned on. So if you go to the view menu, come over here and make sure file name extensions is turned on, because if it's off, you're going to get a .zip extension. You're not going to be able to rename it very easily to an mcpack extension. So make sure that's turned on like I have here, and I'm seeing the .zip file. So what I can do is I can call it exploding arrows, and I'm going to keep the period there, but I'm going to change the zip to mcpack. And when I hit enter, it's going to ask me to change the file extension. And there we go. We have our exploding arrows mcpack file. Now this should be recognized by Minecraft 10 and by Pocket Edition. So what I want you to do is I want you to take this file. We want to get it out of here so we can cut it, maybe go to our desktop and paste it. So now it's on our desktop. You see we've got the Minecraft icon associated with that file. So if I were to double click it right now, it would try to import into Minecraft 10, but since I already have it, it's going to fail because I already have that behavior pack installed. So what we're going to do is we're going to attach this to an email, send it to a friend on an iPad, and then run this add-on that we've created that I just showed you. So make sure you you have a way to share this file with someone. So email, you could text message it, you could use Dropbox, you could put it on a website if you have access to a website. Any web services out there that want to share your add-ons, you could upload it to them and it would be downloadable for people to use. Okay, so now you've got your own custom behavior pack in a ready-to-use mcpack file. Let's go check it out on the receiving end. Okay, now I'm switched over to my iPad mini, and let's see, first of all, I'm going to click on the play button, and we'll do create new world, and I'll show you that I have no behavior packs installed. So as you see right now, there's no behavior packs installed right now, so I'm going to switch back over to my email program. Here's that behavior pack. Dude, try out this behavior pack add-on. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that, and when I click play, create new world, and go to behavior packs, there it is, exploding arrows. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that, and now it's been added into my game. Go to the game properties, I'll set it on creative, I'll turn cheats on, and I'll say give the world a name. Boom. Okay. And then we're going to create the world. And let's see if our exploding arrows works. So first of all, I'll go here and grab a bow. And then I'll grab some arrows. And are we ready? All right, let's try this out. We have to make sure not to hurt any horses or any animals here. Let's check this out. Oh, sweet. Look at that. You could customize the power of the explosion in the JSON file. You could also customize whether or not it creates fire. So you could see here we've got it causing fire after the explosion. Look at that. That's pretty crazy. Pretty awesome. So see, there you go. That is how you create your own behavior pack. Convert it into an mcpack file and then share it with anyone that's running the Windows 10 version of Minecraft or the Pocket Edition. So I hope you found this tutorial useful. Make sure to give it a like and subscribe for more videos. If you've got any ideas or thoughts or questions for more videos, go ahead and leave a comment down below, and we will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.